Hello, everybody. This is Greg Flyshaker, Greg Fly to My Friends, and it is almost 4 o'clock on a weekday, and I'm going to make some hard-boiled or maybe soft-boiled eggs. This is primarily geared towards my children who are off to college with their first apartments and curious how I make boiled eggs. So obviously, first things first, get as small a pan as you can get with enough room for the amount of eggs you're going to cook. So I'm going to be boiling 8 eggs, not because 8 is a great number, it's just the number of eggs I have, and we'll go through them pretty quickly. So you want a pan big enough to hold all your eggs with a little bit of water on top. Now I know some people like to put their eggs in and then bring their water temperature up. I go the other way around and get my water temperature up and then put my eggs in. And I'm actually going to add salt and vinegar before I even put my eggs in. So the salt will raise the temperature of the water, allowing for the water to be hotter when it boils. And the vinegar, theoretically, makes the shell a little thinner. So both those are geared towards making the eggs easier to peel when it comes time. So I'm going to let the water come back to a boil, put my eggs in, and then I'll start the timer there in the background. And the whole theory is the less time your eggs are hot, but still get to your desired doneness, the easier they will peel. So it's the amount of time that the heat is applied to the egg that makes them stick to the shell. So to that point, Adam Sachs, the ex-editor of Savour magazine, past editor, recommends that he actually cracks his eggs as he puts them into the water bath. So I did that with a few of them here just to try it out. The theory being you want some cold water in between the shell and the egg there. So I boiled my eggs for 8.5 minutes, and then I let them soak in a ice bath for at least 15 minutes. 20 minutes won't hurt. So cooked for 8.5, but if you want them a little bit harder done, then you will cook for a little longer. If you want them a little softer done, you'll cook for a little less time. Either way, put them in an ice bath for at least 15 minutes afterwards, so to stop the cooking. And then this is what an egg should look like as you peel it. Instead of getting all those little pits, you want it to come off kind of in sheets. And it would have been helpful if I remembered which eggs I had cracked ahead of time and which ones were uncracked. I think I'm double checking to see which one's which. They both peeled pretty easily, so the salt again allows the water to get hotter and the vinegar makes the shell a little bit softer. You should be able to get your eggs peeled pretty well either way. And then again, I'm going to cut into it here to show you how done 8.5 minutes with my equipment on my stove look, and then you can adjust the amount of time as needed depending on how soft and runny you like your boiled eggs, or if you really want it pretty yellowy and chalky. Just stay away from the green yolks. That's really a sign that you've overdone your hard-boiled eggs. So the whole process took about 45 minutes from beginning to end. Not too bad.